Imagine a world where decoder firmware was only updated every 3 years, and then you were forced to update or your system would stop working altogether. Thankfully, here at Race Result, we strive to offer you the best tools to do your job. In today's episode of Race Result Tech Check, we're going to look at why you should and how to update both your decoder firmware and Race Result 11 software. Now, we've come a long way in the last few years, and next to me here is a 3000 series decoder from around 2012 with the firmware version so old it's not even logged. And check out this screenshot of one of the oldest versions of Race Result 11 we could dig out of our archives, almost unrecognizable in its appearance. But today's episode of Race Result Tech Check is why you shouldn't want to use outdated technology. So let's bring this up to speed a little bit. Now, here we have a brand new 5000S decoder running version 2.48, and you can see we've come a really long way. But why am I dragging on about this again? Well, not only do we want to make sure our timers are making the best of their Race Result solution, but from a support perspective, it becomes increasingly difficult to support products with old firmware. Sometimes we can be trying to diagnose an issue, and it later transpires that the feature they're trying to use isn't actually supported by that device. When we release new firmware, we're mainly bringing out new features and enhancements to make timing easier and more enjoyable. A couple of noticeable improvements last year were the new first and last detection mode, and also the mobile GSM connectivity. The first and last detection mode improves the reliability of detections on a start line without having to change mode between the start and the finish. And if you want to understand more about that, then check out this webinar we did last year, taking a closer look at decoder features. The mobile GSM connectivity was actually completely rewritten from the ground up last year to improve both the reliability and connection speed, particularly when using auto APN. And these are just a couple of enhancements. Other more recent features include the new storage method on the internal memory, support for USB Wi-Fi dongles, and also the antenna number on passive passings files. There's also a ton of work going on in the background to improve the reliability and performance of your decoder. We also wanted to make it as easy as possible for you to upgrade your decoder. That's why it can be done directly from the decoder itself. Simply grab a LAN cable and hook it up to your internet router, or router for our American friends, making sure you have the correct IP configuration for your network. Then simply open the menu and go into the system and check for latest firmware. The system will then ask if you want to download and install the latest version, and this system's telling me that version 2.49 is available, so I'm going to go ahead and do that now. Once done, after a quick restart, I'm all ready to go. So let's take a look at the software side of things. The user interface of Race Result from 2015, whilst maintaining some similarities, is almost completely unrecognizable from what we're used to today. Our development team, and that includes Sunker himself, are constantly working to bring you new features and enhancements. While some of these are obvious, others less so. There's constant work being done to improve the reliability and performance of calculations such as results, ranks, and functions. This ensures the same reliable performance whether you're timing 50 participants or 50,000 participants. The timing module and raw data exporters are a couple of recent enhancements, but it's funny to think that only 18 months ago, raw data mode was still relatively new and not widely used. October 2018 saw one of the largest updates of recent times, with the version number jumping from 11.3, first seen in August of 2016, up to 11.4. And development didn't slow down, jumping to 11.4.12 in just a couple of weeks. Updating software is just as easy as when you first installed it. Simply head over to raceresult.com and open the software download page to download the most recent version. Simply run the installer, which will automatically close your current version of Race Result 11, and you're all good to go. To keep track of changes, both hardware and software revision notes are available in our knowledge base. And I had a good laugh looking at some of the notes from Race Result 10 in 2011, with some things that just seem obvious today. So before writing to support with a problem, please make sure you're running a recent firmware and software version so we can offer you a better service. Now, I'm off to go see what more I can break, test. See you next time, and thanks for watching.